Welcome along to the Boylesports Betzone. I'm Nigel Seeley. I'm sorry if I'm a bit quirky today. I've got a terrible cold, a little bit of flu, but it's not preventing me from giving you some winners this week on the Betzone here. I'm delighted to say making his Betzone debut is former Tottenham defender, winner of FA Cups and UEFA Cups, Paul Miller. Good morning, Paul.
Good morning.
Have you been to the same tailor as me this morning, obviously?
I always dress like this.
Same hairdresser as me, obviously, as well.
Exactly as well, yes.
Looking absolutely dapper as usual.
Well, you know, I always dress like this. You work in the city, you've got to make a presence and stand out a little bit differently.
I work in the city as well.
You do.
Enough about our sartorial elegance and non-sartorial. Let's look at some punting and let's get the money in for Christmas. We're going to start off with probably the Christmas banker, but it's a short banker of that. Man City against Crystal Palace, Saturday at 12:45. Man City odds on here at 10-3. So you put a tenner on, you win £3. Man City have won their last seven matches. Is there a shock on the cards here, Paul?
No. I think Palace are going to make it difficult, but once Man City score, you know, they'll open it up. I think I expect to win 2-3 nil. It's a good game to play before Christmas. I know they have about a couple of strikers at the moment, but they got enough quality in there. I'd probably fancy Frank Lampard to get on the score sheet again because, you know, he loves these sort of games, Frank.
Yeah, Man City have kept four clean sheets in their last five matches. If you don't want to play the short price odds on, maybe City to win 2-0 at even money.
Yeah, I think that's probably your better odds. Look at 2 or 3 nil, even more. I mean, we might even go 4 or 5 because, I mean, Palace haven't taken a battering lately, have they? I mean, no one's really slaughtered them. And I'm not sure about them at the moment. They're still not, you know, they're probably going to do enough to stay up, but maybe it's about time they got a hammer in, yeah?
Mm. 90 could be today. 1990 was the last time Palace won this fixture. Man City won it 1-0 last season. That's 13-2 at Boylesports. 2-0 Man City is a 5-1 shot. And for your double bubble, we're going for first goal scorer.
I'll go for Lampard.
Lampard is 6-1 to score the first goal. Remember, if he scores inside the first 20 minutes, Boylesports will double the odds on that player to score the first, in the odds for that to be 12-1 for Lampard. And that applies to all of the Premier League games this weekend. And as you can see, I'm losing my voice bad, Paul. But I'll soldier on to Sunday, 1:30. Northwest Derby, Newcastle up home to Sunderland, the massive game.
Massive game. I saw Newcastle last night get absolutely hammered at Tottenham. It surprised me they actually won so many games on the bounce because they're not that good a side. They're poor defensively, in my opinion. They're going to be okay. They're going to finish mid-table probably, but I think it's a difficult game for them. I'm going for a draw on Sunday. I think it's a score draw.
If you look at the draws, drawn 5 of their last 6 Sunderland, and they've drawn 12 games already this season. They are draw specialists in the Premier League. Newcastle, the streakiest team in the Premier League, 6 straight wins and now only 1 win in 5.
Yeah, I mean, I say score draw. I think it'd be a really tight game, and I'd say the biggest bet for me would probably be someone getting sent off.
Well, that's going to be a price at all. Lots of yellow cards and lots of red cards usually in this game. And as someone who's played in local derbies as well, it's a different kind of match, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Whether some of these players actually appreciate them, especially the new ones. But I mean, you know, it's quite a bubble up there, isn't it? It's a small bubble, Newcastle and Sunderland, Teesside and Wearside, and I'm sure they've been made aware of it. And yeah, and the atmosphere obviously always is exciting, electric, and I fancy the atmosphere could be better than the game. I don't think it'd be a great game. I think there'd be a bit to keep giving it away. I mean, there's not a lot of quality in the both sides, but and a draw probably suits both of them as well.
Newcastle conceded 4 in their last 2 games against Arsenal and Tottenham, and as I said, Sunderland are the draw specialists, but they won this fixture 3-0 in the last 2 seasons, and that's 40-1, a massive price for Boylesports this time around.
Yeah, I mean, if you want for an outsider, but I mean, I'd probably go for a Sunderland away win.
I like the Sunderland away win a lot. I think 3-1's a massive price.
I think it's the value there for me.
Yeah, a draw obviously from the stats could be the way, but if you bet draw no bet or something like that, you get Sunderland and then the draw run. If you, I think Newcastle are far too short and they could go on a losing run again. Okay, Sunday, 4 o'clock, probably the biggest game in the Premier League this weekend. Liverpool against, I know, your second favourite side, Arsenal. What do you think of this one?
I actually think Spurs and Burnley is the biggest game of the season this weekend, but no, massive game. I think Liverpool, great result last night for them, needed that badly. Big fella for them. Sterling obviously scoring a couple because he missed a few against Man United, didn't he? I mean, go for Liverpool at home. I think they quite like playing Arsenal. It won't be easy. Arsenal, you know, have done well recently. Mm. I just fancy Liverpool at home with the crowd now behind them a bit more.
Are they behind them though?
They will be after winning last night, I think. I don't think Rodgers is under any pressure. He's okay. Well, he's been without his best player all season, Sturridge. If you're missing a player like him with 30 goals, anyone's going to miss him. But if he can, you know, I think Liverpool could win a tight game. Mm. I'd go for 1-0 actually.
Okay, only two wins in their last seven home games for anyone back in Liverpool. They're 7-4 to win this with Boylesports. Sterling did do it against Bournemouth and he missed two crucial chances in the game. A lot of pressure on a young lad's shoulder, isn't it?
There is a lot of pressure, but he's one of those lads, he's lived quite a hectic full life up until he's, yeah. I think I'll go into that, but he's not a shy boy and he'll be okay. Arsenal, to me, are still shaky on the road. Defensively, they're still not right. I think we've had this chat before, they need to buy more players, certainly a central defender and a defensive midfield player, and that's what I think will be their comeuppance. I just think Liverpool will get at them, which you've got to do with Arsenal, not give them time to play, and I suppose my heart and my head is saying Liverpool win.
5-1 Liverpool won. This was all done and dusted in the first 10 minutes last season. Both teams have scored in 8 of the last 13 games. I think both teams will score in this game. Arsenal, though, have won the last two games 4-1. Four different players, two goals a game. Cazorla, Giroud, Podolski, Ramsey. The boys are coming back.
Yeah, I'm coming back, and obviously Ramsey, great goal last week. Top player, actually. I think Sterling will be the first goal scorer. Once he starts scoring, he does it all the time, and with his pace, I can't see many Arsenal players living with him. Like defenders, certainly, and I fancy him as a first goal scorer.
If you look for the double bubble, obviously the first goal inside 20 minutes, you'll get double the odds. Paul's going for Sterling, and I am going for Giroud. No surprise he's going for Sterling. He works in the City of London. OK, Stoke against Chelsea, away game Monday at 8 o'clock. Stoke only won win their last five matches, Mark Hughes' former side, but this is the sort of game they fancy at 5-1.
Well, especially after the last game against Arsenal when they got at him, I mean, he'll be saying the same again, won't he? I think Chelsea are a lot more resilient and a lot tougher. Chelsea relish this, and they've got some quality. I'm not saying Stoke can't win. The first goal's vital in this game. If Stoke score, it becomes a different game. If Chelsea score, they always go on and win. You never see, very rarely see Chelsea score first and not win. So that first goal is going to be the crucial one.
3-2 last season, this was to Stoke. That was their only win in their last 10. And Chelsea usually go here and do a number.
They do. I mean, they like it. They've had a few extra days rest as well, haven't they? Because from the cup match the other night. I fancy Chelsea strongly on this. I think that's what I would think they'll win. But I think Stoke will make it very difficult for them, as they always do.
8-13 you can get for Stoke, 31-10 for the draw, and 5-1 about the home side. For the double bubble, it's all about Diego Costa for me. He's a type of player that Stoke aren't going to bully him, are they?
No, I don't think you can bully anyone in Chelsea team. And Chelsea's matter in midfield, and even the players who can play, Hazard and Fabregas, I don't think they get bullied too much if you can catch them. one of your ex-Arsenal guys, yeah. But I think Chelsea have got too much quality, and they've got a lot of resilience about them. And the three big boys at the back, Cahill, Terry, and Isnovic,
the Serb.
Yeah, with those three in there, they don't care who you are. They're actually, the tougher the better. They come and bring it on.
Yeah. If you fancy Diego Costa, Boylesports are the best price, 130 about him scoring the first goal, and you will get closer to 7-1 if he does do that inside the first 20 minutes. Okay, Paul, what's your nap?
Nap is going to be Chelsea.
Just Chelsea to win, 8-13, pays your money. I'm going to go for a big price away day trip. I need to get some of these suits. I need to get down the hair clinic and get my hair looking as good as yours. So I'm going to go for an 18-1 away day treble. Sunderland, Arsenal and Chelsea. 18-1, Christmas
night. You can have that with me if you want.
Well, we'll talk after. Okay, that's Boy to Boy. It's been the Boylesports Betzone. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you at our Christmas special with Chris Perry, previewing all the Boxing Day games coming up soon.